Well, that was fun. Welcome back, Susan.
So we're here now.
Exact same problems happened to me one day on the Matt and Matt show. I could not figure out why it wasn't switching, and there's an extra little button over there that's either got pushed by accident or...
Yeah. When things like this happen, we just generally, we blame Bryce.
Yes.
Say it's Bryce. But he's not here.
But we, where were we? We were talking about Friday.
Yes, career day.
Tore down the studio. It's probably the reason with a glitch is we had to tear it down and put it back together.
Right.
Set it up at Arnold, not knowing where we're going, found out that we were going to be in a classroom. I'd originally liked to had a little space and had Susan do her segment from Arnold because it would have been pretty cool to have another career yet represented. Could have been both business owner and you're not really a seamstress. What are you? You're just a sewer, you know? What are you?
Well, they call them sewists these days.
Sewists. Yeah.
Never heard that.
Sewists. No, I'm not either.
Seamstress. And they're trying to get away from the gender connotation.
Oh, yeah.
So they don't say tailor and seamstress much anymore. They just say sewist.
Yeah, but you do so much more than like fix a hem. You do.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's why they say sewist.
Okay.
Because it's anything sewing.
Well, anyhow, we were stuck in the music room.
Oh, man.
So we had to slide all the instruments out of the way and set up our studio on the other side. And we made it work.
We actually interviewed a lot of people.
We interviewed.
There was an owl that was interviewed. He didn't have a whole lot to say.
An artist.
A banker. An owl like his...
A banker. A bunch of teachers. The
principal.
State representative.
An Udawal owl. I think he lived in... Oh. No. He lived out at G Creek Campground.
Right.
Okay.
But the shocking thing that Josh and I were talking about when we came in is the fact that... Because what grade were those kids?
Three different grades, third grade.
Third grade, different classrooms. Each class probably had about 10 to 20 kids in each class. Mm-hmm. And the classes were not in there all at the same time, all individual classes. But there's at least one kid who was very, very serious. It was career day, so we go, you know, what do you want to be when you grow up? At least one kid in class all said a YouTuber. They wanted to be a YouTuber when they grew up. And I don't know if they meant like having their own channels or they just wanted to
watch YouTube
for a career. Watch.
Can so, you get paid to do that?
I according to the kids, that one kid said, you can make a lot of money that way. So
I figure they want to make their own videos. Like,
yeah.
There's so many out there now that all they do is YouTube shows.
Right.
And they're legit making a living wage off of it,
right? So
for more,
my wife, she told me that her best friend, who has a younger daughter, who's actually younger than my son, so he's less than 3 years old, but she said that she loves to watch YouTube. Mm-hmm. So kids like three and under are getting online and going on YouTube and picking out their
TV station.
I have a friend that's got a 1 year old and has her own phone, and if they let the battery. And all she does is this number where you push the screen so they go up. Mm-hmm. And so if they let the battery run out where it won't do that, she gets all upset.
Yeah.
We didn't even have phones.
Right.
You know, we had plug-in-the-wall phones. Well, I'm older than you guys, so.
Hey, I remember the rotary phones. Mm-hmm. My mama had a rotary phone. I thought that was the coolest thing ever. Mm-hmm. But anyways.
You always didn't want to dial your friend who had a lot of... all the nines in their number.
Oh, yeah. You got to go all the way around. Wait for it to get all the way back. But
yeah.
Anyways, it was a lot of fun. I want to thank Arnold Memorial Elementary School for letting us come hang out on Friday.
Yeah, that was put together by Miss Wilson. I forget her real title, but I think she's over specials.
Mm-hmm.
So she handles a lot of the placement of getting assistance for kids who need extra assistance, whether it be inside or outside of school.
Mm-hmm.
And then she put together Career Day, too,
yeah.
Which is a huge undertaking. And the other teachers I've talked to said that was the best one they ever had.
It was a lot of fun.
Probably because we were there.
Probably.
Yes, right.
That's our first time.
The party don't start till we walk in. So, you know, anyway.
We're trying to grow into our ego because a lot of people in entertainment have giant egos and we don't really.
Well, I'll bring a pin.
But we keep thinking we should.
I'll bring a pin if you guys start.
Yeah.
Pop it.
Right. Thanks. We appreciate it. Well, since we were at Arnold on Friday, we didn't get a chance to have batting practice, which we had talked about.
Mm-hmm.
We wanted to have We wanted to have batting practice. So, Susan, you have a mountain of things in front of you.
Yes,
you wanna...
I do.
Yeah.
First, I'm going to do a little bit of history about batting.
Sure.
And I don't know if we want to get.
I'll tell you what, let's do this.
Uh-oh, I think Josh is going to take a
commercial for your store so we can come back and start the segment fresh.
Yeah, we're going to reset some camera angles here real
okay.
quick.
So.
How's that sound?
That's okay.
Sounds good to be. We'll be right back.
Quilting have been enjoyed for generations. Hyder Hangout, Quilt Fabric and More in downtown Cleveland is all things quilts and much more. Hyder Hangout stocks a vast selection of beautiful fabrics from upholstery to evening wear and will special order hard-to-find items. Find all the accessories to make any project fun and easy. Hyder Hangout offers expert instruction with classes for the beginner and the advanced. Ready to show your style? Get to Hyder Hangout, Quilt Fabric and More, 219 First Street Northeast, downtown Cleveland.
And it says good morning, but yep. There we go.
We're back.
All right. Are we close here?
I think so. Here we go.
Okay.
So let's talk about the history of what we got
history
here.
History of batting. Well, one thing is if you're in the United States, this is called batting. But if you're in England or Australia, it's called wadding.
W-A-D-D-I-N-G.
And it was kind of interesting. I was on a Facebook page, and some of the girls were saying, well, where do y'all get your wadding? And we had to figure out that they was talking about the same exact thing. But the batting is what is in the middle of the quilt.
Okay.
Okay, we're over here. The original first batting was they would take cotton balls, and they would have to take the seeds out. So hand by hand and lots of hours, and they would just lay the cotton down. And they would just, until they got the whole thing covered up, however big.
Mm-hmm.
And then they would pretend this is the back of the quilt and that's the front. And then they put the other on top, but it'd be however long it takes. So sometimes days, because they'd have to take all the seeds out of the cotton.
Right, and depending on how big your quilt is.
And so that case, since their cotton is apart like this, they would also have to quilt closer together so that when you washed it, it wouldn't fall apart. They would either do that with the cotton. Uh-huh.
So you don't want to have too much separation in between.
Right.
Okay. I see. That makes sense.
And they would do that with the cotton, and they would do that with wool. And there's a lot of people that think if they get an old, old quilt and it's real thick, that it can't be that old, that it has to be with polyester. Well, you need to watch because it could be a wool quilt.
Right.
Wool batting in the quilt. Now, I brought all kinds of different ones, and we'll go over them a little bit, but there's a little sample card that you can get at Hyder Hangout.
Cool.
And it has the little different battings. And if you guys want one, do you guys want one?
Yes, please.
Then you can have a test next week. I'll tell you which kind of batting is which and how far apart you...
Well, I don't know about all that.
You want one, Josh?
No, we'll study the same one.
You'll say, okay. He's afraid to take the class.
Yes.
This is the one we have at the shop.
Big one.
And
that's got a lot.
And it's got where you can touch the different ones.
Ooh.
And on the card, it does tell you how far apart. So you take the bottom, and it tells you.
There you go. Shut that.
Here we go. I'm upside down. Tells you how far apart.
Okay.
And a little bit about them. And it's, it tells you about it. Specially engineered, man-made fibers, inherently flame resistant. Well, I just picked this one. This is a Dream Angel, but I'll show you a little bit about the other ones. So this is a sample of the different ones you can get.
Okay.
You have different purposes, different costs.
Right.
The more polyester they have in them, the more economical they are. I'm just going to grab these as I grab them, and we'll go.
Sure.
This is what they call Dream Cotton. And Dream, name Dream is, it happens to be the company that I have some with, but I have a couple other companies too. But Dream Cotton and Dream Quilters Dream Batting is the company that I carry, and I can get special orders from them within about 5 days.
Okay.
But all these are small craft size packs.
Mm-hmm.
So you can see that some of them are thicker than others, but their craft size is like 46 by 36, but they have all these different sizes available here.
Yeah.
And one thing that I like about Quilter's Dream is they have what they call a super queen, which is what a lot of people will use in their king, and then the king size is even bigger. So they have additional sizes available that you don't have to go way up to the king size. But the 100% cotton, and it tells you on here, it says soft and warm, and it tells you it's carded, cross-lapped, needle-punched. Now, this company does not use a chemical to hold the cotton together. They use needle punch.
Okay.
So there's two ways to hold your cotton together so that it's a sheet rather than falling apart thing. This is the cotton, and it's a sheet, and this is one of their thickest. But see how it's...
Yeah.
It's a lot better.
You can't pull that
apart. And what they do is they work on the cotton and get it all cross-lapped. The fiber's this way and the fiber's this way, and then they needle punch it with thousands of needles, go in, punch it, and it gets it in there so that it's together.
So it uses itself to kind of bind itself
right.
by the punching. They're not putting a thread in it. They're just punching it.
Punching it together. Okay. There are some that use a chemical or a sheet of other fiber that holds it together, but this company doesn't use those. And this is a natural color. I don't know if you can see. This is a natural, and this is a bleached white, but it's hard to see in this light. But this is bright white, and this is a natural. This is the color cotton comes.
Mm-hmm.
So if you go with that, you pay a little bit more when you get a bleached, because it's another process that they have to do.
If it's inside of a quilt, does it matter?
It doesn't matter, except for if you have a whole lot of white. And you don't want it to dull it out, because if you have a whole lot of white fabric, you can see the dull part.
You can see it through there. So if you have white, you want white.
Right.
So you
some don't. People do and some people don't, and they'll put their fabric up against it and say, well, that's okay, I don't care, or yeah, I want the white.
Right. Well, that makes sense. If you have a lot of white on your quilt, but you want it to make sure that it looks white, you don't want to put like the green one in there.
You don't want to put the green or the pink or the
it's going to look like a mint or Pepto Bismol quilt or something like that.
Yeah. So this is the 100% cotton, and there are traditionalists that say you have to have 100% cotton.
You said traditionalists.
Is there another alternative? There are people that give themselves all kinds of rules.
Gotcha.
And they have to have everything 100% cotton.
Then there's these progressive liberals.
That are 50% cotton, 50% polyester.
Well, we have.
Well, do the traditionalists also pull their own cotton and pull the seeds out?
I always wonder that, because they say, well, you've got to do it all by hand, and you have to, pull the cotton and all the traditionalists. But I'm like, okay, the sewing machine was made in, remember we said, early 1800s. Mm-hmm. So if you're a traditionalist, you still could use the sewing machine.
That's true.
And the cotton gin was in early 1800s.
Right. And, Eli Whitney.
Yes. You knew that. Mm-hmm. Very good. And the first cotton gins were a little bit worse than the others, and they didn't get all the seeds out as well as, and they kept advancing, and finally got to where the cotton was really well that you get all the seeds out.
Nice.
Okay, this is a 70-30, 70% cotton, 30% polyester. Now, polyester was developed for World War II, and it is a little bit puffier. So this and this is the same size, but see how this one's a little bit thinner than this one.
Yeah.
So it's a little bit puffier when you've got the dream, when you've
does
got the blend.
Does it also help with shrinking as far as when you wash with the
poly
blend?
Right. The cotton has, and it'll tell you, this particular company does not have as much shrinkage as some of the batting people, but you're right, the polyester will not shrink as much as the cotton. And, of course, there again, there's that traditional thing. People that like the traditional-looking quilts like the batting to shrink. So if you have the cotton shrinks up, it'll shrivel up, and it'll have that bumpy look on your quilt. Some people wash their batting first. That's very hard to do without tearing it. You know, if you put it in the wash machine and it...
You mean just put it in there by itself and wash it?
Yes.
Really?
I would not do that. I don't care that my quilt will crinkle up a little bit, but there are some people that don't want that to happen.
Right.
So they'll wash their batting. To me, that's too much work. Because you have to be careful about it, and you have to lay it out flat to dry, because if you dry it in the dryer, it ends up being a big ball. And
I was going to say, right, how are you going to wall it? Another cotton ball?
Yeah, I'll be back to the cotton
ball. Big cotton ball. So anyway, this is a blend. The blend, there is blend that comes 80-20. A lot of companies do 80-20 or 70-30. This company does have an 80-20 blend, mm-hmm. but this one is, if you're going to do a blend, this one's fine. The cotton, 100% cotton, the natural fibers are easier to hand quilt than the others. So if you have polyester in or one of the man-made fibers, they're harder to poke the needle through. So yeah. if you're going to hand quilt, you do want a natural fiber.
Didn't know that.
So it's not as malleable and adjustable as something just
Well, and just
cotton.
Poking your needle through it, you can tell. I didn't bring a needle. I could have let you guys try that.
And I noticed one of the samples in here has three, and then one of them is a different color. Is there...
Okay, that's three different... They have three different... This one actually has four different thicknesses.
Okay, I see.
The one that's a different color is a polyester, and we got one of those here.
Okay.
Cool. The cottons do not dye well and hold the dye good, so if they do a dark one, they will do the artificial fibers, the polyester. Now, this is the different thicknesses, and of course, the thicker it is, the more expensive.
Yeah.
So, and this particular company has their request thickness, their select thickness, deluxe, and then of course supreme. And you can see that the supreme is almost double plus on the request thickness. So I don't know if you can. Mm-hmm. Do I need to go over?
Yep, no, we see it.
You can see it on that one.
You can see it there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and that's a cotton and the poly blend. What do I want to do next? This is a Dream Angel, and this is made with man-made fibers, and it's flame retardant, and it's called Dream Angel. And I don't know, they don't tell you what fibers, because it's a proprietary.
Ah, yes, they can't let out
the
recipe.
They're engineered inherently, that's a big word.
Yeah.
Flame retardant, no chemicals added, but the fibers are flame retardant. It doesn't say flame proof, but it's retardant, and they will not melt or flow when they come in contact with flame. So like polyester, if you put it in flame, it'll melt and gum up and everything, and it says on here it passes the California 604 test for open flame resistance, and it feels real nice, and it's it does do well on hand quilting, and you can stitch it about 6 inches apart, so it's pretty good, and it can be hand washed, can be machine washed.
Nice. And there's another one over there that you had.
Well, I have all kinds of ones.
You have the different colors there. You have
oh,
pink,
he's
you have
so
green.
Curious about this one. Okay, this is the Dream Poly, and it's 100% polyester, and this particular company, their polyester is not real puffy unless you get to their puff.
Okay.
But when you say polyester, most quilters think puffy.
Right.
The ones that they have, the more economical battings, I do have some of those. Mountain Mist has a puffy one. I'm trying to think of some of the other Pellon makes a puffy one, but this is 100% polyester, and it's black. So if you had a dark quilt,
right,
you want to use a darker batting. And see, it's black, and you've got your little sample here.
Do you get any problem from bleeding from the first time if you
no.
put those? Okay.
No,
like if
this
you're
going
to wash
the
quilt.
It's polyester. Quilt. That's okay. Why they don't do it on cotton.
Okay.
It's 100% polyester, so that it's color fast is what you were asking, if it was color fast.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So this comes in packages, and I do have some on a roll, so you could roll off however much you want, and we cut it. It's I'm trying to remember if it's 90 wide or 108 wide. It's a big roll.
Mm-hmm. Right, and that was going to be my question with the packs that you have is how much can you get out of each? Because each one, of course, is a different length. I mean, what is your recommended, like, if you're going to do, like, a full-size quilt? Like,
well, if you get to do a full-size quilt, you go on here and say, well, my quilt is, because if you say full-size, it's,
right.
You know, it could be a throw size, it could be a twin size, or it could be a double size.
Right.
So they have on here, well, let me just hand you, let you look. You want to look at the, see the sizes at the bottom?
Aha. Uh-huh. So it tells
you. So you look, you know, people says, well, I want a full-size quilt batting. And I said, well, what does your quilt measure? And sometimes it ends up that they can use a twin instead of a double,
right,
on the size. And then
if you're trying to put one on a king size bed, you're going to need the.
Well, you know, sometimes the king size will use the super queen.
Okay.
People come in, I says, I need a king size batting, and I said, well, do you want?
Yeah, do you want the super queen or the king? Or just,
you know,
cover it?
Because if they come in and they say, well, my quilt's, you know, 120 by 93, the super queen will fit. And they're surprised sometimes that there's that size. And it saves them, it saves them a bit of money. Any savings is great, right?
Right.
So to answer your question about the black one, that's the only colors other than these others. And these are because they're a specialty. And we'll get to these other colors in a minute.
Okay.
But this black, and it's a poly.
But that's 100% polyester.
It's 100%
right?
Polyester, and the reason is because
the color.
Because of the color.
So if you wash it, it doesn't bleed out into your the rest of everything. Okay, that makes sense.
And the Dream Poly comes in white, in midnight black, and see they have the white here, and then the black, and it talks on here, and it tells you, you read a little bit on here, and it talks about excellent for tied quilts. Those are the quilts you don't do the stitching through. You put the little string through, mm-hmm, and just tie them, because you can do this up to 12 inches apart. Whereas the cotton, they say only about 6 to 8 inches apart.
Right.
The higher the polyester, the further apart you can quilt it or tie it or whatever.
Now, if you're going for warmth, what would you recommend as far as, like, I want a really, really warm quilt?
Well, here we go.
Just the big mama. Here we go.
Where we go?
That's
what's
a big
that
one.
Say? Dream wool.
Dream wool.
And it is puffy, and you can see right here. This is the wool.
Is it very lightweight? Like what's inside of a comforter? You know,
yes.
A comforter's really poofy,
comforter
but
is
light.
Poofy.
Yeah.
But it's not real, real heavy. See, the wool is a natural fiber, but it also gets a little bit thick. You've got your thickness on it. And I wouldn't think we would need anything heavier in our area than the wool. Mm-hmm. But you can put a cotton and a wool together. You can put, you know, three different battings in there if you really want one.
It's a pretty thick quilt.
Pretty thick thing. But if you're wanting warmth, natural fibers, number one, mm-hmm, and then thickness. So the wool is a puffy, and it's nice. And this is fun. It's nice to hand stitch. I mean,
I'm sure it's probably easier to work with.
It's very nice and soft and drapes well, and it doesn't have there. This company doesn't have any of this. I just thought of the other thing. Scrim is the sheet they put in to hold things together, and resin is the chemical they put in to hold. So some of the battings are made. This company does as much as they can without having to use extra chemicals and stuff. So they make this wool without the extra scrim or resins.
No fillers.
Right. No fillers.
No fillers. Cool. And then we have some pink and we have some green.
Okay. And let's go to the other natural fiber first, and then we'll come to the pink and the green.
This is
Dream Orient. And I'm going to get my notes here because I don't.
Yeah, I'm looking at my booklet for that one.
The booklet, let me see where.
I don't know if it has that one in there.
I may not. And did you get one of these little?
I got the Dream. Oh, no, it does. It does. Here we go.
Here's a pink, too. I don't know that your booklet has the pink in there because that was a relatively new one. Okay. And it's got bamboo, silk, and botanic tinsel, which is a plant fiber. And I don't know if this particular company has a patent on using the botanic tinsel, but this is really neat and wonderful to work with hand.
And unlike the wool, this one doesn't have any resins or scrims or binders. Okay.
And And this is available on only one thickness. They don't have a call for the thicker. Plus, it's a little more expensive.
So the blending of the bamboo and the silk, I guess, makes this.
Yeah, and the tinsel. And I forgot. And they put a little bit of cotton in this one, too.
And okay, so you can machine wash and you can machine dry it as
well. Right. They try to make them so that if you give a quilt to somebody that has no idea how to take care of quilts, that they don't have to put it in the bathtub, soak it, and then put it out in the...
So I would need a dream orient for my quilt.
Well, all of them wash, but you want the dream orient. Okay, coming to the colors, this green one, dream green, and it's made from recycled plastic bottles.
What?
Feel it. It feels almost like the cotton, does it not? But it's 100% recycled plastic bottles.
There's my dream green. Okay, I see. Oh, it is kind of, it's very soft.
Yeah. And it's closed the loop manufacturing process, and each pound of this equals 10 bottles that were saved from the landfill. The big bottles, you know, the...
That is very interesting how they were able to do that.
Yeah, it's the same as...
They're using that for carpet.
You can't...
Are they really?
Yeah, carpet. They're making carpet out of that.
Right. And you can't really tell the difference. If you have your blindfold on and you're feeling it, the regular polyester batting and this, you can't really tell the difference. The only thing different is this is made from recycled bottles. Mm-hmm. And the green color, and I think it's just that the color, they were having a whole bunch of different colors come out because of the different bottles, so they decided, well, we're going to put just a smidgen of dye in there to make it.
Well, plus it's green. It's the whole green movement. It's recycling.
Right.
They pulled all the bottles
out of
landfill.
But they put the color in to make sure, except for the light green natural bottle color, that's the color that the bottles... The green bottles come. So they use a white and green bottles, but they correct the color so that it's the same from batch to batch.
And it actually feels a little bit smoother than the Dream Poly.
I think so.
So I don't know if it has to do with the
manufacturing process or the fact that it's been through the manufacturing already once, but it's a good, and it can stitch up to 10 inches apart, so it's pretty cool. The only thing is, if you have a light fabric, you want to make sure put it on there that it's doesn't show through. Mm-hmm. But a lot of people use it, and it's a little bit more economical than some of the different ones.
And when it says on here, because I'm noticing I'm reading all these the differences between these, and there's it mentions exceptional drape.
Okay,
so that's talking about like how
the quilt,
so it will drape over, so it's not so
stiff
that it just
folds. Yeah, it's smooth and it drapes well.
Okay, and yeah, it says it's the green because I guess it is a little bit softer than the poly. It says it's really good for it gives you a good drape. The recycled material.
Oh yeah. So people think recycled. They're thinking plastic.
Right,
bags.
I mean, especially you think a plastic bottle. And you think it's going to be a little bit like tougher, but it's actually a lot smoother.
Yeah.
So it's very unexpected.
Yeah. So. And the thing about all the polyesters, it resists any kind of wrinkling and
right. So you're not having to iron it after you wash it and try to get it all pressed down. Okay, cool.
Okay, and then we have...
Well, this one's very cool, the pink. That's the
pink.
Next one.
Okay. Did you read what it said on there?
Yeah, I'm going to let you...
This is an 80-20, so it's 80% cotton, 20% polyester. And the polyester gives it a little bit less shrinkage and holds up a little bit better, and you can quilt it a little bit further apart. But the Dream Pink is relatively new for this company. I think sometime in the last year and a half. And some of these cards don't have it. And I gave him the little insert. There's a little insert that we put in there, and it's got the little piece of the Dream Pink in there. And it is 10% of their sales goes to metastatic breast cancer research.
That's right. It also says it's available in select soft. That's, is there...
Select Loft, L-O-F-T.
I got Select Soft. I don't
okay. know. Well, it's soft. Feel it. It's excellent.
I was going to say, it's kind of rivaling the green.
Yes.
It's very soft.
And it's got the, what it is they've got the different lofts, like we talked about here. So it is available.
Different thickness.
Right. It is available in, they didn't make it in the thinnest. They made it in the most common one.
Gotcha. Okay.
The thinnest one people use if they don't want a whole lot of thickness in their quilt,
right.
or they're making table toppers. Because if you have like a placemat or a tabletop, if it's
right.
polyester thick, it'd be falling over.
Right. Well, would you recommend if someone wants something that's thicker than this, would you recommend them just going up to a different type
of different yes.
loft, or would you ever recommend stacking?
You can stack if you want.
As long as you stitch it.
Yeah. Economical-wise, if you go to the next loft, it's probably more economical than putting two lofts on there.
Okay. And I figure probably stacking two of them, you would have to sew it and make sure it stays in place.
Right.
Otherwise, you're going to get some...
Well, you have to do that with any of the batting.
Okay. Okay.
You have to... And they tell you on there how far apart to stitch. And I have people that come
in... So this one's 8 inches apart.
Right.
Gotcha.
Which is pretty far. It used to be you had to do... You know, when you had this... When you had this...
right.
Where are we?
Yeah. Let's go there. There we go. Yeah, that would be that would be really tough to work with.
Yeah.
How many quilts have you done having to use that type
I never used this. This is before my time.
Just set, not even just to say, let's see how difficult this would be.
All my mamaw's quilts have had that bumpy feeling
yeah.
from
and
the where it all
open
moved
it up
around.
And figure out that it was this kind of,
yeah
because was this was probably,
hand-pulled.
You know, I forgot to look the date up on when they started to do the ones with the scrim and the needle punch and all that in it.
Yeah.
But I do know there's some 40s quilts that have this in it.
Mm-hmm.
I've got one at the shop that's a 1890.
Really?
And it's got this kind of, you know, you can see there's a couple holes in it, so I, you know, out of curiosity look to see what, you know.
Yeah, what's in here? Yeah.
What's in there? They did use newspapers.
Really?
During, especially during the World Wars.
Gotcha. Whatever you
know, cotton was not available, and then they would use the newspapers or the Sears and Roebuck catalog for the batting. They did use old quilts that were worn out, because if you spent hours and hours and hours doing this on a quilt, and your quilt normally what wears out was not the batting, is the outside layer. So the outside layer would wear out, and they'd say, okay, we're going to use this quilt and put a new top on it. So sometimes if you get an antique quilt, you maybe end up with two quilts, or you end up with a whole bunch of newspapers that you could read.
Nice. All right, so Josh, you got one to pick. You're going to make your quilt. Which one are you going to go with?
I'm going to walk into Susan's shop and go, what's the go-to?
Okay, what is it? Well, that's a good question.
Well, what's it depends.
If you're going to make an everyday quilt tomorrow, just something I want to sleep in every day, what are you going to grab? Officer?
Oh, if you're going to sleep in every day. Well, mm-hmm. see, I probably would do, if you're going to sleep in it that much, you'd have to be washing it more, so I'd do a polyester.
Okay.
So you're going to go dream poly. Josh
right.
is a dream poly guy. He
right.
I didn't show
the dream puff. I didn't have one in a
that's
package.
That's the last one, yeah.
Yeah, but this is real thick. And this polyester puff, this company, this is the thickest that they make. But there are the, I won't say cheap, but economical companies that make them all the way up to an inch thick. But they're harder to work with.
Yeah.
And
I would say that this one is more closer to the old school traditional, like the torn apart one. Like
right.
this one, you can see that this has like some... It separates a little bit because,
yeah,
it's so puffy.
And this it tells you how big the loft is. But if you're wanting real puffy, you'd get one that's this company doesn't even carry, but it's a real puffy thing. But I you know, that's comforters or whatever. But if you're going to spend all that time and do that all that quilting, you don't want
1.5 times warmer than a down. So that's what this says, the Dream Puff.
The Dream Puff, yes.
So it's 1.5 times warmer.
And it also won't breathe as much either, though.
It's true. Very cool.
If you're, to answer your question, depends on what you're going to use it for. Mm-hmm. So if you're going to use it every day and you're going to have a lot of washing, I'd say something with polyester because it does hold up better than the cotton. However, if you
and
wash...
And the colors won't bleed.
Right. And how, but your batting's not going to be but one color anyway. So the batting is not, doesn't matter. It's the rest of the quilt. If you're going to put it in a kid's quilt, you've got this, the Dream Angel, which mm-hmm. is fire retardant. Mm-hmm. Some people don't worry that much about it. But if I do a kid's quilt, I'd either do the Dream Angel or 100% cotton. Because of the way if it burns, the cotton doesn't melt. It burns in its ashes rather than sticky junk.
Right.
It just depends on what you're using it for. You know, if you want to help with the donation, you can do the pink. And some of the girls that that come in and do charity quilts will get the pink. Oh, I want the pink because I'm donating it anyway. So.
Now, did you do the Dream Fusion?
I didn't bring a Dream Fusion, but thank you for asking.
Do you want to use this real quick?
I have that right here.
Okay. So I'm sitting here reading. This is very interesting.
Maybe it's not on here, this one. The Dream Fusion, let me grab that. You got that right there?
Mm-hmm. That's right there.
What the Dream Fusion has is it has a iron on it, both sides.
So how would that iron on?
What you do is you place your quilt, mm-hmm. put the backing down,
right.
Put your fusion down, put mm-hmm. your top down, and you take an iron and you just, so what it does is instead of having to pin
right.
or spray your batting down, because mm-hmm. there's a spray to hold it,
yeah.
You can iron. It's not a real heavy glue. So it is able, you can pull it out if you ironed a crease in or something. Yeah. But you have to iron both sides, so it's a little bit harder. To me, okay. I would rather pin the layers together. So where I use the Dream Fusion would be maybe in something small.
I was going to say, like, if you maybe had something small that you wanted to do, you're not having to stitch or pin. You can just iron it and it'll stick. But you have to iron both sides.
You have to iron both sides, but then you still have to stitch it.
Okay.
Because it tells that you can stitch up to 12 inches apart. Where the Dream Fusion, a lot of people use these, like inside the purses, placemats, vests, that kind of thing. And
something
holds it in place.
You're just wanting a little bit extra.
Right. Well, okay. See, the purses, there's two or three different ones that you can put in the purses. But that's a whole nother.
That's a whole nother show.
That's a whole nother segment.
Yeah.
Anyway, there's that.
Cool.
Any other questions? There may not.
Josh, do you have any additional questions?
Here's your jimmy-jigger back. Sample.
Cool. So you would go with the Dream Poly. That's more
for
your everyday quilt.
Mm-hmm. Right. If he was using it and
I would want to have something I'd see all the time and use. I would want to use it every day. No, I wouldn't look for a showpiece that I'd have to hang on the wall.
Right.
Be like,
now, for what he's talking about, like more of like a showpiece, more of an artistic piece that you really don't want to actually put out there for people to actually use. You're just wanting it to be decorative or something like that. What would you recommend as far as like what's the Mercedes of batting?
Mercedes of batting probably
your super classy quilts.
Probably is the Orient or the wool.
I picked the Orient.
Depending on whether or not you wanted a lot of, if you're doing an art piece.
Is it the silk edition?
Well, it's just it is easier to work with. Okay. And if you're doing an art quilt, you do a lot of hand stuff usually. If you're doing an art quilt, there are art quiltists that will do 100% machine. But a lot of the art quiltists will add a lot of embellishments. And it's probably the easiest thing to sew through by hand.
Okay, nice. Cool. Right on. And any of these products, if you are interested in starting your own project, your own quilt, I'll go ahead and throw this up here real quick. You can go to hyderhangout.com, 423-715-2908. Give Susan a call. Or you can swing by her store, which is down on the First Street Square, 219 First Street in beautiful downtown Cleveland next to Trailhead Bicycle Shop, as well as right across the street from the Catch restaurant. So you can go by and take a look at some of these samples for yourself and figure out what...
Well, you can get one of those sample cards if you come in and say, I want one of those sample cards. Yeah, I'll give you one.
Yeah, and I recommend plenty of them. And I do recommend that after sitting here, like going through all the differences in all these and the different ways that you can use them and how you have to put them together, I would recommend getting one of these and looking at what you want to use before just jumping right into it. So,
right.
Otherwise, you could be halfway through a quilt and realize that, well, maybe I didn't want to use the Dream Fusion. I wanted to use the Orient, or
right,
or maybe I should have went with wool, you know, something like that.
Right. But we can help you too if you have.
That's right.
As long as you know what you want to use the quilt for.
Right.
If you come in, you don't have any idea, then we try to guide you. But.
Well, thanks for coming in, Susan.
Nice. Well, yeah. Thank you. And we will have you back on Friday?
Wednesday.
That's right.
Make and up for Friday.
Yep. Oh, Wednesday and Friday. Okay.
Wednesday will be binding.
Okay.
I don't know yet what Friday will be. Next Friday, the 24th. Or is that the 20? Yeah. Is Friday the 24th?
I believe so.
How come when you put this on, your alarms don't even go off? I thought you were supposed to. Okay, anyway.
17th.
Friday the 24th, huh?
17th is next, this coming week, and then the following week is 24th.
24th yes. will be the state coordinator for Quilts of Valor, and she's got a couple of Quilts of Valor quilts that she's bringing.
Sweet.
And the Monday after that, I have a girl that's a Janome dealer, and she's going to bring a couple of Janome sewing machines and show you the difference between bottom of the line and top of the line sewing machines.
Cool. Okay.
But as far as Friday, I don't know yet what Friday will be, but we'll let you know Wednesday.
It's going to be a surprise, Josh. Get ready. So, well, thank you, Susan, for coming by. We'll take a quick break, and we'll be back with a few more things. I heard rumor that possibly Wendy Benton was going to come in today, but I'm not sure. We'll have to wait and see.
Okay.
So thank you, Susan. We'll see you guys in a couple minutes. We'll take a quick break.
Quilts and the art of quilting have been enjoyed for generations. Hyder Hangout, Quilt Fabric and More in downtown Cleveland is all things quilts and much more. Hyder Hangout stocks a vast selection of beautiful fabrics from upholstery to evening wear and will special order hard-to-find items. Find all the accessories to make any project fun and easy. Hyder Hangout offers expert instruction with classes for the beginner and the advanced. Ready to show your style? Get to Hyder Hangout, Quilt Fabric and More, 219 First Street Northeast, downtown Cleveland.